ಗಣೇಶಾಯ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಸರಸ್ವತ್ಯೈ ನಮಃ ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ನಮಃ ಶ್ರುತಿಸ್ಮೃತಿಪುರಾಣಾನಾಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಭಗವತ್ಪಾದ ಶಂಕರಂ ಲೋಕಶಂಕರಂ ಸಮಸ್ತಜನಕಲ್ಯಾಣೇ ನಿರತಂ ಕರುಣಾಮಯಂ ನಮಾಮಿ ಚಿನ್ಮಯಂ ದೇವಂ ಸದ್ಗುರುಂ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮವಿದ್ವರಂ ಮೂಕಂ ಕರೋತಿ ವಾಚಾಲಂ ಪಂಗುಂ ಲಂಘಯತೆ ಗಿರಿಂ ಯತ್ಕೃಪಾತಮಹಂ ವಂದೇ ಪರಮಾನಂದಮಾಧವಂ ಪರಮಾನಂದಮಾಧವಂ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಸಾ ಇನ್ ದ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಸೆಷನ್, ಜ್ಞಾನಂ ಕರ್ಮ ಅನ್ ಕರ್ತ divided into threefold. Jnanam is our vision of the world of objects and beings. Karma is a very action that we undertake. Karta is a very individual which undertakes the action. So, a vision with respect to the world, an action is taken up by the performer, by the doer, by the individual. With a vision, an action by the individual. All these three were divided. The vision of unity of Advaita is sattvika. The vision of Dvaita is rājasika. And the vision of narrow-mindedness, the vision of onlyness, illogical onlyness, this is tamasika. So all-inclusive vision is sattvika. A vision of diversity is rajasika, and the vision of narrow-mindedness is tamasika. And when one comes to karma, that action which is performed, that action which is a duty, first of all, that is performed with the karma yoga bhava by one of the karma yoga bhava is sattvika. That action which is performed with selfishness is rājasika. So the action performed selflessly is sattvika. The action performed selfishly is rājasika. And the action performed in delusion is tamasika. And when it comes to the doer, the one who performs with the karma yoga bhava is a sattvika. The one who performs with desire is rajasika. And the one who performs with delusion is tamasika. Naturally, an action performed with selfishness will have to have a selfish doer. You will find a lot of similarity between karma and karta, which is only natural. As you are, so your action will be. Your action is nothing but a reflection of you. So, if you feel that they both are similar, you are right. You are right. A selfish action will have a selfish doer. A selfless action will have a selfless doer. A foolish action will have a foolish doer. It has to be that way. It cannot be but other way. Right? In this way, very beautifully, Bhagavan has classified, is classifying, is going on. As he mentioned right at the beginning, he made a pratignya. I shall now explain to you the threefold jnanam, karma, karta. Right? Now, in the order, now comes karana. And the most important karana we all have is our own buddhi. You may say indriyas are also karana. Yes. But the indriyas, the organs of action and organs of knowledge, are controlled by the buddhi. Therefore, the karana of karana, the karana of karana, the instrument of instruments, is our own buddhi, is our own intelligence. And now that buddhi is being classified into three types. Buddhi has got various thoughts. Buddhi, when I say antakkarana, okay? Antakkarana has many thoughts. Many thoughts. But when we think of action, when I say many thoughts, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, etc., 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 many thoughts are there. Hrir, dhir, bhir, kama, sankalpa, vichikitsa, shraddha, ashraddha, hrir, dhir, bhir, ityeva, madin. Brahdaranyaka Upanishad. No need to translate. Kama, sankalpa, resolve, vichikitsa, doubt, shraddha, faith, ashraddha, disbelief, etc., etc. Many thoughts are there. But here, in the context of action, when we need to identify that factor among various thoughts which enable us to go to the conclusion of action, to the end of action, to the very summit of work, and not give up in the middle, one specific function of our buddhi is to be taken up. What is that? And Bhagavan takes it as dhṛti. Dhṛti is a perseverance. Dhṛti is a come what may, I will go to the end. This only completes an action. Our Gurudev used to say, there are some who, in spite of obstacles, complete. There are some who, because of obstacles, stop. And there are some who, because of fear of obstacles, don't take up anything. If at all there is a factor in us which makes us see the end of the work that we take, that is perseverance. And therefore, along with buddhi, even though perseverance is also a facet of buddhi, antakarana, Bhagavan Sri Krishna highlights it. Not only here, even in the context of the highest meditation, he would say, Shanai shanai ruparame buddhya dhriti grihitaya. There also. Atma samstam mana kritva nakinchitapi chintayet. He's talking of the third kind of sannyasi, where he is dissolving the mind in the self. There he says, buddhya dhriti grihitaya. Buddhi and dhriti, there also he brings. So no wonder, in the 18th chapter, the concluding adhyaya, he again brings to our attention buddhi and dhriti. Okay? Now, let us see buddhi and dhriti in today's session. Now, let us read verses. I think first let us read the verse 29. And then we will go to the three divisions.
Buddhērbhēdaṃ dhṛtēśchaiva.
Buddhērbhēdaṃ dhṛtēśchaiva.
Guṇatastrividhaṃ śṛṇu.
Guṇatastrividhaṃ śṛṇu.
Prōchyamānamaśēṣēṇa. Pṛthaktvēna dhanañjaya.
Pṛthaktvēna dhanañjaya.
Buddhērbhēdaṃ dhṛtēśchaiva. Guṇatastrividhaṃ śṛṇu.
Prōchyamānamaśēṣēṇa.
Pṛthaktvēna dhanañjaya.
Buddhēḥ bhēdaṃ dhṛtēśchaiva. We have to start from dhananjaya. Have you seen dhananjaya in this verse? Last. Hey dhananjaya, O Arjuna, I shall now explain to you śṛṇu. Whenever śṛṇu is said, you listen. You listen. You listen means what? And there's something important I'm going to tell you now. Listen. It's a command. Śṛṇu. What? Buddhēḥ bhēdaṃ. I shall speak to you the bheda. The bheda, the variety. Dhṛtēśchaiva. And also the difference in dhṛti. Buddhi, mind, intellect, intelligence. Dhṛti, perseverance. Dhṛti, the give up not spirit. Dhṛtēśca, I shall speak the bhedam, the difference. Trividam bhedam, I shall give the threefold difference. And the threefold difference is based on what? Guṇataha. Gunata, based on the gunas. Based on the gunas, based on sattva, rajas and tamas. And this prōchyamānam, which I'm stating, prōchyamānam, aśēṣeṇa. I shall explain to you without leaving any point. Śeṣa is reminder. Aśēṣeṇa, aśeṣa, without any reminder, meaning I shall give you a comprehensive idea about it. listen to it, I shall give you a comprehensive analysis. And how will I give you a comprehensive analysis? Pṛthaktvēna, by taking each one separately and separating each other in terms of sattva, rajas and tamas. By classifying them, I will give you a comprehensive idea. That is the meaning. When you want to give a total picture, you start classifying. Right? I shall give you. So in this way, Bhagavan makes a pratignya. I shall teach you this. Right? The best way of teaching is, I shall teach you this and finish it and then tell you, I have taught you this. This is a method of teaching. In Bhagavad Gita, you will find how to teach also. It is worth doing a postdoctoral degree on the pedagogical methods adopted in the Bhagavad Gita. You can, pedagogy, method of teaching, way of teaching, worth doing. Beautiful tips you will get, how to teach. First, you see in this word, śṛṇu. Many teachers just keep on talking, not getting the students' attention. Śṛṇu. Especially when you keep on telling one thing after another, classifying one, then next, then two, and then again go to another, one, two, three, again go another, one, two, three. Students' mind can become tired. Śṛṇu, have to catch. And then you encourage, when you say śṛṇu, listen, you must give reason why you want the other person to listen. I shall explain to you comprehensively. At the same time, prepare the student by classifying it. Therefore, the mind always go, okay, classifying. One, two, okay. Guṇataha. Three gunas. Oh, that means what? It is going to come in threefold way. Trividham. Prepare the student and then teach. Now, how is he teaching? Let us see now. Verses, next three verses together.
Pravṛttiṃ ca nivṛttiṃ ca.
Pravṛttiṃ ca nivṛttiṃ ca.
Kāryākāryē
bhayābhayē.
Bandhaṃ mōkṣaṃ ca yā vētti. Buddhiḥ sa pārtha sāttvikī. Yayā dharmamadharmaṃ ca. Kāryaṃ chākāryamēva ca. Ayathāvatprajānāti. Buddhiḥ sa pārtha rājasī. Adharmaṃ dharmamitiyā.
Adharmaṃ dharmamitiyā.
Manyate tamasā vṛtā.
Manyate tamasā vṛtā.
Sarvārthān viparītāṃśca.
Sarvārthān viparītāṃśca.
Buddhiḥ sa pārtha tamasī.
Tamasi.
Pravṛttiṃ
ca nivṛttiṃ ca.
Kāryākāryē bhayābhayē. Bandhaṃ mokṣaṃ ca yā vētti.
Buddhiḥ sa pārtha sāttvikī.
Yayā dharmamadharmaṃ ca. Kāryaṃ chākāryamēva ca. Ayathāvatprajānāti. Buddhiḥ sa pārtha rājasī. Adharmaṃ dharmamiti yā. Manyate tamasā vṛtā. Sarvārthān viparītāṃśca. Buddhiḥ sa pārtha tamasī.
That buddhi is sattvikī, which has got clear comprehension. Clarity is there. True understanding is there. Nothing is more important than then clarity in life. A sure recipe of failure in life is absence of clarity. With clarity comes success. In confusion, failure is inherent. And therefore, what is sattvika buddhi? A sattvika buddhi is that buddhi which is crystal clear and keeps you guiding in the right direction. It is the greatest blessing. In my mother tongue they say, buddhikku taganda sugam. Buddhikku taganda sugam. Your happiness depends upon your buddhi. Correct thinking is such a very difficult thing, such a rare thing in fact. Correct thinking. Thinking is very difficult, that's why most people don't think. Very difficult. There are people who tell, ask me to do anything except think. You tell me what to do. Right thinking is the greatest gift you can ever have. Wrong thinking is the greatest enemy you can ever have. You become your own enemy. That is sattvic buddhi, which is your lifelong friend. There can be no better friend than your own mind. And there can be no better enemy than your own mind. Is it not? You are your friend and you are your enemy. When you have your mind as your enemy, you need no other enemy. And when you have your mind as friend, no enemy can conquer you. That is a power. Mind maketh a man. Woman also. Mind maketh a human being. Right? So what is sattvic buddhi? Sattvic buddhi has got clarity. The nature of sattva is to provide clarity. The nature of rajas is to agitate. And the nature of tamas is to blind. And that characteristic of sattva, rajas and tamas impacts upon the buddhi, making it sattvic, rajasic and tamasic respectively. So what is sattvic buddhi? Clarity in what? Clarity about the whole life. Not just about something. To have clarity about a topic. And to have clarity about life. Sattvic buddhi gives a holistic clarity. What do you mean? Pravṛttiṃ ca nivṛttiṃ ca. Pravṛtti, to act. Nivṛtti, not to act. Pravṛtti, to do. Nivṛtti, to not do. First of all, clarity on what to do and what not to do. It's a very big thing. Confusions arise often in action. To do or not to do. To be or not to be. Remember? When there is clarity, pravṛttiṃ ca nivṛttiṃ ca. Pravṛtti and nivṛtti also means how long to work in the world, when to stop working in the world. Pravṛtti, nivṛtti. How long to work? Karma marga, pravṛtti. Nivṛtti, jnana marga. Some people keep on working selfishly till the last breath. And everybody calls them, he lived like a karma yogi. Have you seen all these kind of nonsense happening? What he lived like a karma yogi? He destroyed everybody's karma. Pravṛttiṃ ca nivṛttiṃ ca. Kārya, akārye, bhaya, abhaye. In all these points he has got clarity. Kārya, what ought to be done. Pravṛtti, karma marga. Nivṛtti, jnana marga. In karma marga and jnana marga, what is kārya? What is akārya? In karma marga, kārya is niyata karma, what ought to be done. Akārya is phala akāṅkṣa, phalāsakti and saṅga, akārya. Phalāsakti, desire for fruit. Āsaṅga, attachment, the focus on the self. What is kārya in karma marga? Niyata karma is kārya. Now what is niyata karma? What is duty? Many times so many confusions. What is duty? In this occasion, what is duty? What is duty? Kārya. Akārya. What ought not to be done? In nivṛtti marga, what is kārya? Śravaṇa. Manana, nididhyasana is a kārya. And what is akārya? What should not be done? That should also be clear. In one's own spiritual pursuit in sadhana, what should not be done? What should be done? Clarity. Bhaya, abhaya. What we should be afraid of? What we should not be afraid of? We should also have fear. Fear is important. God has gifted us with fear. Fear for doing wrong should be there. If that is not there, it'll be terrible. Long back I read an English proverb. Fools tread where angels fear to enter. Am I saying right? Fools rush where angels fear to tread. But mine is better. Fools enter where angels fear to tread. Fools rush where angels fear to tread. Whatever. Fear is very important. What to be afraid of? Many times parents tell the children. They tell with young children. Always think. Because the child will not know what to do, what not to do. Always think. If you do this, will your father be happy? Think that and do. Is it not? Did we not receive that advice? Think. Bhaya, abhaya. Not only that. Bandhaṃ mokṣaṃ ca yāvetti. That buddhi which is able to comprehend what is bondage and what is liberation. What is bondage and what is liberation? What is actually the problem with me, bondage? How do I get liberated? This whole map, which map? Sannyasa 1, Sannyasa 2, Sannyasa 3. In Sannyasa 1, what is gained, what is lost? In Sannyasa 2, what is gained, what is lost? In Sannyasa 3, what is gained, what is lost? In this way, a life map should be clear. Because that is bondage and that is liberation. Bandham mokṣaṃ ca yā vetti. What can bind me? What can liberate me? What is the nature of bondage? What is the nature of liberation? When should I get bound with what? When should I get liberated from what? How to get liberated? How to get bound? When you know how to get bound, you will also know how to get liberated. The problem is we get bound without knowing we are getting bound. Daddy, will you every day go and fetch milk? Daddy is 75, 78. And this daddy, 75, 78, old man says, yes. Bandham. Every day go fetch milk. No, I am useful to my family. You have sufficiently been useful now. Now relax. When one is a brahmachari, what to do? When one is a grahastha, what to do? When one is vanaprastha, what to do? When a sannyas, the whole clarity is there. Bandham mokṣaṃ ca yā vetti. This is called as sattvika buddhi. In other words, what is sattvika buddhi? Clarity. Everything is clear. What is right and wrong is clear. What should I be afraid of? Clear. What should I not be afraid of? Clear. What should I do? Clear. What should I not do? Clear. Clear. What is going to bring me bondage? Clear. What is going to liberate me? Clear. Everything is clear. Anything is clear. All is clear. Perfect. Life will be. When there's clarity, there'll be fearlessness. When there's doubt and confusion, there is always fear. The power of clarity is unmatched in life. Is it clear? Then it is sattvika buddhi. What is rājasika buddhi? Rājasika buddhi is that buddhi which has thought but is not able to conclude. Thinking is a very difficult thing and many people get lost en route. And getting lost en route in thinking is called confusion. This buddhi also thinks, but this buddhi has not got the clarity. Rather, this buddhi has got confusion. So a clear buddhi is sattvika buddhi. A confused buddhi is called as rājasika buddhi. Explanation. Yayā dharmam adharmam ca kāryam akāryam eva ca, meaning everything. Dharmam adharmam, earlier it was said, no? Kāryam akāryam bandham mokṣaṃ, all those things. Bhayam, abhayam, all those things. This buddhi also puts mind to understand, puts its effort to understand. But then what? Ayathāvatprajānāti. It does not understand it as it is. It doesn't understand it as it is. Ayathāvat, na yathāvat. Not exactly. Not exactly, it doesn't fully comprehend. Swami Vivekananda, in a context, he says nicely, an atheist is a person who has started thinking about God but has not completed his thinking about God. When you get lost in the labyrinth of your thoughts and meet dead ends, that is called a rājasika buddhi. So, what should be done? I'm still thinking. Should we go now? My fourth round. Should we give this to that beggar who is coming and asking? Did you lock your door? Where is your mobile? Rajasika buddhi. Are you hungry? Doubting Thomas. Rajasika buddhi. The buddhi is thinking but not concluded. It is lost in its own thought. And such a person, when they have to express, when you ask them a question and they give an answer, you do not know what the person has said finally. This way also, that way also, this way also, that way also, this way pros, that way cons, this way pros, that way cons. What, you're writing a book or what? I asked you a question. No crystal clear answer. Themselves confused, confusing others, embodiments of confusion, such lovely souls which embellish this world are all rajasika buddhis. Swamiji, don't scold me. Wait for the tamasika buddhi. That is so beautiful. Next word. What is tamasika buddhi? If sattvika buddhi has got clarity, rajasika buddhi has got confusion. In Sanskrit, we have a beautiful word for confusion. Confusion is called doubt, dilemma. Confusion is called sandeha or samshaya. Both are beautiful words. Samshaya comes from the root shi, which means to sleep. Shete, sleep. What is doubt? Doubt is that because of which knowledge sleeps. Yasmat jnanam shete sa samshayaha. Sandeha comes from the root dah, means to burn. Because of which knowledge is as good as burnt and dead. Tamasika buddhi. Dharmam. Adharmam dharma miti ya manyate tamasa vrta sarvartan viparitanscha buddhisa partha tamasi. Hey partha, that is a tamasi buddhi whereby everything is understood the opposite way. Adharmaṃ is considered to be dharmaṃ. Dharmaṃ is considered to be adharmaṃ. Bhayam is considered to be abhayam. Abhayam is considered to be bhayam. Kāryaṃ is considered to be akāryaṃ. Akāryaṃ is considered to be kāryaṃ. Everything oppositely he understands. You explain everything to that person. What did you understand? He will tell you opposite of what you told. Exactly opposite. This kind of buddhi, which makes wrong assumptions and jumps to conclusions. I had a very nice joke. What is your husband good at? One lady is asking another lady. What is your husband good at? Good at jumping to conclusions. Misapprehensions. Total wrong understanding. How many kinds of sannyasa are there? Three. Suppose you answer how many kinds of sannyasa are there? There's nothing called sannyasa. There are people like that. O is Aum. We should not chant Om like that. Where you got the idea? I'm innovative. What? Totally opposite. And then they will tell you, but you told like that. Huh? I told like that. Did I tell like that? You get doubt about your what you told also. So whenever you talk to that person, keep one more person. So that you are saved. Because other fellow will, that fellow will quote you as you told like that. Then you can ask, did I tell like that? No. Tamasavrata. Veiled by tamas. When it is veiled by tamas, then knowledge cannot function. That is a problem. Dharmam adharmam iti ya manyate. He thinks. Why? Tamasavrata. Because of veiled by tamas. Sarvartan viparitan. Everything he understood in opposite way. Contrary fashion. Such a buddhi is called as tamasi. But Atman is kevala. Main point. O mat bulna. Atman is kevalam. This is trigunatmakam. Even in the tamasic buddhi person, Atman is kevalam. Buddhi is tamasi. Buddhi is rājasī, buddhi is sāttvikī, Atman is kevalam. Swamiji, in the tamasika buddhi, what does Chaitanya do? Same, nothing. As in sāttvika buddhi, nothing. As in rājasika buddhi, nothing. But Atman must be doing something, no, nothing. It is not doing anything. Everything happens in its presence. Buddhi can be sāttvikī and it gives a sāttvika functions. Buddhi can be rājasī and then rājasika functions. Buddhi can be tamasī, tamasika functions. But Atman itself is pure. In its presence, the tamasic buddhi functions in a tamasic way. In its presence, the rājasika buddhi functions in a rājasika way. Sattvika buddhi functions in a sattvika way. Petrol is petrol. It helps the vehicle go. But with that vehicle, if you have an accident, don't blame the petrol. Can anybody go to the court of law and say, this whole accident would not have happened but for petrol? Arrest the petrol, not me. self remains pure. All right. Now, let us go to dhṛti. See, remember, the tamasika person will have a tamasika action, will have a tamasika vision. And with the tamasika vision, the person will perform a tamasika action. And the tamasika person with the tamasika buddhi will have a tamasika understanding. You understand? The dhṛti also can be sāttvikī, rājasīki, tamasīki. Let us read. Next three verses together.
Dhṛtya yayā dhārayatē manah prāṇendriya kriyāḥ
Yogenavyabhicharinya
Dhṛtissā pārtha sāttvikī
Yayā tu dharma kāmārthān
Dhṛtyādhārayatē'rjuna Prasaṅgena phalākāṅkṣī
Dhṛtissā pārtha rājasī
Yayā svapnam bhayam shokam Viṣādam madam evaca Navimunchati durmedha Dhṛtissā pārtha tāmasī Dhṛtyā yayā dhārayatē
Manah-prāṇendriya-kriyā Yogenavyabhicharinyā
Dhṛtissā pārtha sāttvikī Yayā tu dharma kāmārthān
Dhṛtyādhārayatē'rjuna
Prasaṅgena phalākāṅkṣī
Dhṛtissā pārtha rājasī Yayā svapnam bhayam shokam
Viṣādam madam evaca Navimunchati durmedha Dhṛtissā pārtha tāmasī
Sattvic dhṛti is that dhṛti, that perseverance of the highest order, which enables you to attain the highest realization, makes you perform the greatest sacrifice of renouncing the mind. Sannyasatri, remember? In Sannyasatri, what happens? The mind is renounced in the self. There you require this highest dhṛti. That is the subtlest action. It is not a gross action. It is a very subtle action. The mind turned inward. Yogena. By the practice of Nididhyasana. A single flow of thought, Aham Brahmasmi. No other thoughts. That dhṛti which that perseverance which makes you continue at that highest level of meditation. A single file and flow of thought. Aham Brahmasmi. Yogena. Avyabhicharinya. Avyabhicharinya. Without any diversion. Without any vijatiya vritti. Only the same sajatiya vritti, Aham Brahmasmi. No other thought. Any thought comes, shh. Yogena avyabhicharinya. Manah pranendriya kriya. yayā dhṛtya dhārayatē. All the various actions resolved in the self. By the practice of samadhi. That dhṛti, because of which you conquer the mind. Dhṛti sa pārtha sāttvikī. Meaning, that dhṛti which helps you attain the ultimate liberation. That jīvan mukti. Buddhi is there. Knowledge is there. But the knowledge fructifies itself through dhṛti. To hold the mind at single pointed attention. To make the last thought come to an end. To make the last thought come to an end. This is the highest of all accomplishments. First we learn, then we become clear, then we practice meditation. Meditation also is an action, a flow of thought. That action by which you become actionless. To take up that culminating action, to make the thought thoughtless, to make the mind mindless, and to lose that very effort because of which you have become thoughtless. Because if you maintain that thought, the mind will always be there. How to persevere in such a way the mind ends? This dhṛti is sattvikī. Very subtle perseverance. It is a perseverance, but not a gross perseverance. If the gross perseverance is there, mind will again wake up. It is a perseverance whereby the perseverance is of the nature of nirodha abhyasa. It's a technical term. Nirodha abhyasa. Abhyasa, the practice. The practice of cessation. Usually we perceive to do something. Here is a perseverance to not to do anything. Dekha? You persevere to do, but here you persevere to not do. Why? Even a thought is a doing. Can you persevere to not do? At this level, then it is sattvikī. So sattvika dhṛti bestows moksha, bestows nirvikalpa samadhi, bestows jīvan mukti. One becomes a sthita prajña by sattvika dhṛti. What is rājasika dhṛti? A rājasika dhṛti is also a dhṛti, a perseverance. But the topic of perseverance is not this. Among the four puruṣārthas, dharma, artha, kāma and mokṣa. Dharma for gaining puṇya, artha for gaining wealth, kāma for gaining pleasure. All these three, if one perseveres, all these three or one of the three. So the ambit of function of the rājasika dhṛti is not self-realization. Is with respect to the world. Dharma, artha, kāma. What is the meaning of dharma here? Gaining puṇya. Gaining puṇya. The word dharma can mean good action. The word dharma can also mean gaining puṇya. The word adharma can also mean a negative action, adharma can also mean papa. That dhriti whereby a person perseveres for dharma, artha, kama is a rājasika dhriti. Yayātu dharma kama arthān. See the word. Dharma kama arthān. Yaya, through which. Dhriti, one strives for dharma, artha, kama and attains that. I want to become a billionaire by the age of 38. Yes, you can. If you want, you can. And you will. Because dhriti will make all the difference to persevere. I want to master everything in the field of computer science. You can. You will. If perseverance is there. I want to have the best mansion. I want to purchase an island. I want to. You can do anything with dhriti. Everything is possible if perseverance is there. Nothing works like work. But if the topic of that perseverance is dharma, artha, kama, then that is rājasika dhṛti. It will keep you in samsara. It will take you to dukkha more and more. It will give you a semblance of sukha. So at the age of 38, you become the richest, you become a billionaire, multi-billionaire, you become a trillionaire also. But after 38, your birthday, that day night, you have a heart attack. You may not have a heart attack also, you may not have. That is a different matter. It is not to say if you earn money, you can't be spiritual. No, it's not that. Spirituality is an attitude. Money is no hindrance for spiritual life. If your attention is not in money, it is no hindrance. The attention should be always on the higher. But if the attention is on wealth, if the attention is only on how to accumulate punya for the... Punya also is a kind of wealth, subtle wealth for the future. And if the attention is only on pleasures, to enjoy, that kind of perseverance is called as rājasī. Okay? So what is sāttvikī? Takes you to mokṣa. What is rājasī? That which keeps you entangled in dharma, artha, kāma. And what is tamasī? Yayā, because of which svapnam, bhayam, shokam, vishadam, madam. Swapnam, sleep. Bhayam, fear. Shokam, sorrow. Vishadam, tiredness. Madam, pride. Because of which one doesn't drop. One doesn't drop. Because of which? What all? Some examples. Swapnam. Swapnam, sleep. One doesn't drop sleep. Sleep or sleep? Can you sleep? Yes. Can you sleep anywhere? Yes. Can you sleep anytime? Yes. Can you sleep in any posture? Yes. Can you sleep always? Yes. Swapnam. Bhayam. Always afraid. Why are you afraid? No, I'm afraid. But why are you afraid? No, my nature is to be afraid. But why? No logic, no reasoning. Always in tenter hooks. Always in agitation. Hurry, relax. Shokam. We all go through some sorrow sometime or the other. Everyone will have to go through. But to hold on the sorrow for years, that is a perseverance, is it not? Can you be sad always? This person can be. What happened? Why are you sad? 25 years back, I had a beautiful cat. Kya hua? That cat fell from the roof. Huh? It broke its leg. 25 years back. And then what happened? I took to the vet. Then what happened? And the vet said, this dog, this cat cannot be helped. I'm still sad. There are some people who congratulate them for the love they have for animals. They are also tamasic people. This foolishness. You have to get rid of sorrow next moment. Life is not meant to be sad always. Our Gurudev, you say, jump like a rubber ball. Not like an iron ball, fall flat and stay. Vishadam, madam, madam, pride. Nobody can be proud always, correct? This person can be proud always. Madam, it takes perseverance to be this way. This kind of perseverance. Navimunchati durmedha. Durmedha, this ignoble person, this person of bad intelligence. Navimunchati, never gives up. Dhṛtiśa pārtha tamasi. This is tamasic dhṛti. Dhṛti is always holding, is maintaining your effort to moksha, is sattvika dhṛti. Maintaining your effort and perseverance to attain dharma artha kama is rājasik. And maintaining your effort to remain foolish. Against all odds, I remain foolish. That I remain happily foolish. There's a happiness in being sad also. And making others sad also. This is called as tamasic. Alright? But the self is kevalam. And as a karma yogi, never have the tamasic or the rajasic dhṛti. Okay? Alright. Tomorrow we'll take up what? Wait. One more three is there. The final three. Final three. All right. I conclude. Remember I told you the difference between second chapter and 18th chapter? First session, what did I tell you? Second chapter is highly philosophical. 18th chapter is highly practical. See? Oh. namada purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vashishyate om shanti shanti shantihi harihi om shri gurubhyo namaha harihi om.